Usually, before I go shaking my tits for the press, I like to go see how the professionals do it. Some might say the chief of police has no business in an institution like this, but in fact, enough to be my sons, and they'd rather just hire prostitutes. Why stare at some boobs when you can take the whole package for yourself? But there's none of that in our club. Even looking too long is considered indecent. You can get an occasional glimpse, like by accident. The rest of the time you just pretend that you're immersed in conversation, or just come by for a drink. Doesn't mean these gentlemen wouldn't want their bald heads smothered in tits. It's just that nobody says it out loud. My younger colleagues might call it hypocrisy, but I call it the good old-fashioned manners. Good manners and leave the rest unsaid. She agrees to unbutton her blouse, and we agree not to pay too much attention. The girls are on a quiet prowl, too. They're looking for a way out of their cramped rooms. Maybe make friends with some wealthy patron with a pacemaker and dentures. Everybody wants something, but we have to control ourselves, or we'll all turn into libertines and prostitutes. Hell.
Thank you. 510 in progress. Looks like we have a situation here. 215 complete. 412 in progress. Officer on scene. Looks like we have a situation here. Officer on scene. Looks like we have a situation here. Thank you.
It wasn't letting me use. Oh my god, I swear. Now look at this. Hopefully I fixed the chat.
Looks like we have a situation here. 10-10-8. 5-11 in progress.
Thank you.
9-11 in progress. Progress.
Santa Rae's 10-1, sorry. Well, Jack, who's your favorite right-hand man?
Francis Kendrick, but go on.
A very good lawyer. Very good. Invented a way for you to keep your job. Though invented is hardly the word. He has a whole scheme. A big plan. I just had him on the phone. He's so full of ideas I could hardly get off. Believe me, Jack, this guy knows his stuff.
Wow, I do not know what to say, Martin. That's wonderful news. Can I meet him?
Yes, of course. He's not a local. Right now he's in court on the other end of the country, but he'll be with us in 8 or 10 days. When he gets to Freeburg, we'll sit down, the three of us, and we'll work through the details.
Sounds great. And now you want something from me?
Not at all. Yes. No. Well, I mean, part of his plan is a big public campaign for your support. Talk to the press, lots of interviews, maybe even a few street demonstrations. And it would be nice if your family was there with you. I know you're not talking with your wife, but maybe your children could...
No. Listen. My oldest son and his fiancée have arranged some sort of a trip around the world. A big 7-month tour. His girl's from a wealthy family, so they're taking him with them, along with my younger kids and a few of their friends. They're out there roaming the world, and I'm glad they're away from, well, you know, all of this. They don't even know that I'm getting fired, and I'd like it to stay that way.
Okay, Jack, I thought you might say that. No problem. Oh, it's been a rough day. I think I'll go home and sleep it off.
Martin, wait. Look, you mentioned that you know Laura and me aren't talking, and, well... You think you could help find her?
Jack, I understand that's been hard on you, but I think we should focus on your retirement problem. We finish this, then we'll figure something out, okay? One thing at a time.
I hear what you're saying, Martin, but... Jack Boyd.
Well, Jack, you ready to listen to me ramble for an hour or two? I've had a very busy day.
Almost ready. Bear with me 1 second. Yes, Martin, you're right. One thing at a time. Thanks again. Go home and get some rest. We need your strength. Now I'm ready.
I'm 13. Progress. What's that in progress? Progress. progress. Looks like we have a situation here. 613 complete. 113A in progress.
Thank you.
12 in progress. Officer on scene. Looks like we have a situation here. 1312. Looks like we have a situation here. 412.
12A in progress.
progress. Looks like we have a situation here. Progress. Progress. 9 has been completed. 311B in progress. 412A in progress. 11 complete. 712 We've got a situation here. 311 complete. 10-10 in progress.
10-10 Mr. Boyd, Kevin Paulson is here. He wants to talk.
Kevin Paulson. Tell him to fuck off. Jack Boyd, Super Cop.
Why the half a million, Jack? Why?
Lana, what happened?
Does this sum have some kind of special meaning?
Lana, I don't know who told you about the half million, but it's much more complicated than you think.
Oh, it's complicated, all right. It took me an hour to go over all the documents. There's even a few pictures and a lot of answers. Except for one thing. Why half a million?
What documents? How did you get them? What's in them?
I think you know very well what's in them, and the one who sent them is obviously a big fan of your criminal talents. He even has a cute name for you, Cupcake.
Remember when you told me you're always surrounded by old men? I'm the opposite. I'm surrounded by children, 9-year-old boys. From their first day of work, they gather in the smoking lounge telling jokes about what they'll do when they loot their first million. But it's more than just innocent jokes. It's quickly becoming a reality. They themselves are surprised how quickly everything happens. They buy their own houses, they buy a car, they get promoted. The first million is soon followed by a second, a third, a fifth. Like children, they have no idea what they're getting into. But I'm not like that, Lana. I'm not like them.
You're saying you're not like them because you're only stealing half a million?
I only meant
that... You know, Jack, I'm done worrying about people not taking me seriously. They'll know I mean business when my first act as public prosecutor is throwing the city's former police chief in prison.
Lana, you can't just read over some papers like this and... I told you not to let him in!
I'm sorry, Mr. Boyd. I tried to stop him, but you...
Lana, we need to talk.
Jack, you're so amazingly patient with people. After all the confusion over the past months, all the humiliations, it's really quite admirable. I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. I gotta admit, I'm not nearly so patient.
Send someone in here, now!
I've been thinking, Jack. When I take your place, I'll have a lot of opportunities. For example, I could arrest you. You know it wouldn't be hard to find a reason. You obviously don't want that, right? I don't want that either. Given your reputation, arresting you would make me very unpopular. And if we both don't want that, let's find a way out. My suggestion is you retire tomorrow, and I promise I'll let you leave in peace. I swear, Jack, if you...
Mr. Boyd, there's a call on line two. Mr. Boyd, you really have to take this call.
Boyd!
Jack, it's me.
Laura, I...
Jack, I don't know what you wanted to say to me, but please, just say it. Jack, I'm hanging up the phone.
Laura, you... Oh, my God. Laura. Hey, you remember years ago? So many years I've lost track. But do you remember when Dylan was down with the chicken pox and he couldn't sleep? We kept him occupied until he passed out, and then we went downstairs, sat on the floor, opened a bottle of wine. Who could blame us? Well, we sat on the floor and opened our bills and joked about how poor we were. Remember? And then I jokingly asked if I'd be your hero if I made $1 million. And you sat there lost in thought like you needed to seriously think about the answer. You were quiet for a while, and then you laughed and said that I'd be your hero even if I only made $500,000. Do you remember, Laura?
Jack,
Do you remember?
Honestly, Jack, no, I don't remember.
You don't remember? But that
was... Jack, you've been chasing me down for so long to talk with me. For this? That's all you wanted to tell me?
How can you not remember? It's important, Laura. It's important.
Goodbye, Jack.
Mr. Boyd, are you all right? Mr. Boyd?
Yes, you caught me again. And again, I promise, this is the last time. And now you say again that I've said it all before, but I'm...
Jack Boyd is awake.
Jack Boyd? He opened his eyes? He can talk?
Talking, yes. More like yelling, trying to escape from his room, brawling with the nurses.
Good heavens, he's a tough son of a bitch.
Jack! Lord, were you already discharged from the hospital? I thought you might be down a couple of days or even...
Emma, get me the mayor. Emma, please call the mayor of Freeburg, Stuart Rogers.
Connect. It's urgent.
This is Jack Boyd.
Jack, you've got to take better care of yourself. How's your...
I'm Freeburg's police chief. I came to work. Stop trying to get in my way.
Someone causing you trouble? We just wanted to make sure somebody was holding down the fort while you were recovering. But don't worry about a thing. I'll take care of everything tomorrow morning. You won't be running into Paulson again.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Glad we understand each other. Tell Martin Stett to call me.
What? You don't know? Lieutenant Stett went missing about 2 weeks ago.
Fuck my life.
I suppose Freeburg's mayoral election is just a play with a predictable ending. But I'll take my place on the stage, if only to show them that the people will find a way to support those who want change, even in a city where everything is controlled by a corrupt mayor. The crooks can falsify the voting results.
While acknowledging that he himself is the mysterious Robespierre, Eugene Chaffee has also promised that he will accept any punishment for the crimes committed by him and his supporters. But, in his words, not before the city authorities are held responsible for the dead in our streets and the millions they've stolen. Eugene Chaffee went on to say that this is the worst time...
12 in progress. 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 Thank you. 9-11 in progress.
Ash trying to raise 10-1, starting soft spot.
2-16 in progress.
Trying to raise 10-1, starting soft spot.
5-10 113B in progress. 1011B in progress. 1011B. Looks like we have a situation here. 11B in progress.
My God, Mr. Boyd, there's no tea in the whole house. We've looked everywhere. I could bring you a nice box of Japanese tea. I think you'd fall in love.
Let's get this over with. The people on the street are freezing by now.
Oh, yes. I do apologize for the ill-mannered crowd. A man in my position deals with a lot of unpleasantness.
Mr. Boy, don't you wonder why Mayor Rogers so easily gave you your job back?
I promised the doctors I'd think less.
Funny. The people of this city are in the opposite situation. They've begun to use their heads for the first time in many years. They've learned to argue, but of course they can't agree on anything. Does Freeburg need change? Should the old guard give way to a new generation of politicians? Would I make a good mayor? Was Stuart Rogers a bad mayor? All these arguments reek of naivete, but let's be charitable. Many of them are allowing themselves to doubt for the first time. What's important is this. In times when the people cannot reach an accord, what they need is something to unite them. And one of those things is their undying love for their chief of police. People can support me or hate me, can defend Rogers or demand his resignation, but they remain sure of one thing. Their police chief is a saint. Their police chief won't let the city fall to chaos. And despite everything, the events of recent months have only improved your reputation, Mr. Boyd. The people have been touched by your recovery from that coma, your eagerness to return again and again to your post. To serve the city. And, of course, Stuart Rogers, whose position is seriously shaken, wishes to take advantage of you.
Rogers understands that he won't survive this fight. He just wasn't prepared for it. He intends to storm Eugene's house, burn everything to the ground so the pillar of smoke can be seen from anywhere in the city. He wants you to personally lead the assault. When he offered armed resistance during his arrest, Eugene was shot and killed.
What are you going to do about it?
What should I do? Respond in kind, of course.
What, you're going to storm City Hall?
Don't have the stomach for it, Mr. Boyd.
My job. I want to keep my job. Not 1 year, not 5 years, but until I decide it's time to leave.
I told you, Eugene, he's no longer interested in money.
Oh, I'll take the money, too. It'll be nice to get a bonus when you extend my contract.
You ask for too much, Mr. Boyd.
Oh, really?
I'll visit you in a few days, Mr. Boyd. Gather your strength. You forgot them in my car the last time we met.
Thanks, but I gave them up. Might add a few years to my life.
And one more thing. I wanted you to hear this from me. Consider it a gift.